which I was involved in very beginning, a long time ago. And I saw it was this piano, so we could only have that kind of music that I played, because the piano was so whacked out of tune that you couldn't do much more.
Was that more ragtime, or would you consider some of the jazz, or what were you playing and why?
You know, I don't really, the one song I know that I'll ever recognize was Elton John's Philadelphia Freedom, which was one of my favorites, just because of the way. But actually, together with Dan Orlock and myself, I'm one of the founders of the San Jose Dogs. So I kind of did it with a walking door.
And then what do you think of this project?
I think it's too bad it can't be anything.
And what did you find special about it?
Well, just being able to come down here and find a piano. Most of the time, I got to preface this by saying piano players are the most derided of all musicians now. It's just that we never have a piano to play. You know, guitar players can always carry their guitar. Sure, you can carry a keyboard, but it's really difficult just to sit down and play, like on a corner, for example, your piano, unless you do a major move.
And now getting this opportunity?
Well, I'll do it again if I can find another one. Except I'll do it in downtown, not in Santana Row. Downtown needs the support.
And why?
Because we're trying to become a vibrant city again, and this is part of it.
And what's your musical training? What do you do for living?
Me? Musical training is I took music until forever, in my early years. And I didn't major in college, but I had a successful rock and roll band. I had a good record. Toured, and then the old classic story, Vietnam brought us. And we all broke up, and then went back into music for a while. And then I took over a family business, which was a restaurant called Roots Village, which we closed 5 years ago.
What do you do nowadays?
We reopened the Roots Village.
So you run a restaurant?